Hi, I'm Stephen. Welcome to CT Films. Today I thought we'd do something a little bit different than my usual videos, since even though I was thinking about getting a certain VR game, but it doesn't have AIM support and I'm doing something particular this Friday anyways. However, as you may have known last week, a certain miniaturised console came out last week, and I would have got one. But I decided not to, despite there were some issues performance-wise I've been hearing since the past following week, I should say, and it's just not receiving well, unlike another particular miniature console. Hint, hint. But either way though, but I already own quite a number of PlayStation-related stuff anyways, because there are multiple ways and to play PlayStation today, even without the PlayStation Classic, I should say. Because you can actually, play stuff like the PlayStation TV, for example. I know it's quite a bit expensive, but, you know, you get money's worth owning the PlayStation TV like I have. And you can get most of the games that were listed on PlayStation Network comparing to the PlayStation Classic. I'll just show you the PlayStation Classic list and scribble off them. Ones that you can already get on PlayStation Network. So you can get most of the games right on PlayStation Network as it is. And if you have like a PlayStation and TV, which I know most people don't have, or PlayStation Vita, or PlayStation Portable, you know, PSP I should say, or PlayStation 3 in general, but heard the PlayStation 3 is not a good experience for running PlayStation emulators, and then it is using like a PlayStation TV or PlayStation Vita or PlayStation Portable, which is better, I should say. But I do actually own a particular PlayStation console anyways, even though that would capture some stuff. But sadly though, I can't use my PlayStation TV, for example, because of the blooming HDCP thing. Because most PlayStation users have that problem, and luckily they fixed it on the PlayStation 4 side of things. But luckily though, I do have a particular console, and there's a PlayStation 3, which I'm currently capturing with my Gata capture card, and luckily it works on my PlayStation 3, and despite utilising my PlayStation, you know, emulators, well, not say emulators, you know, stuff that I got on the PlayStation Store, which I only got some of them at the moment, as you can see. But I do have some particular ones in hand, which kind of works on my PlayStation 3, I should say. But other than that, though, I thought it'd be nice to look back at some PlayStation games since, the PlayStation Classic came out and I'm not kind of getting one. I thought it would be a nice nostalgia, I should say. So the first game we'll be playing, that is Medieval, even though I don't have it originally. I do own the sequel originally on PlayStation. But I actually got this on PlayStation Network one time, and I thought it'd be nice to play this, which will be quite nice. And just while Cookie's mentioned, sorry for the audio bleed, because I'm currently not using my Turlbeach headset, because sometimes my Turlbeach headset can't be compatible on certain things. So I'm just doing the audio bleed, and plus it makes it easier to sync up when editing, because my Gata catch card somehow, you know, cuts off when I preload a different game. Anywho, so we'll start a new game and play some good old Medieval. I'm really looking forward to the remaster next year. Even I have dabbled with this game before, because my stepdad, though, has a PlayStation, I should say, at the time. But I was more into a certain console, I should say, at the time in my childhood. But at the meantime, though, you know, I did dabble with the PlayStation back then. But I've just been, most of them been playing other consoles at the time, I should say. But it's nice to play somewhat nostalgia when using, like, say, using PlayStation 3. Because it's got good backwards compatibility the PlayStation 3 had. You can play on other devices like, you know, the PlayStation TV, PlayStation Vita, PlayStation Portable, PSP and whatnot. Anywho. But yeah, it's been a while since I last played this. I did play a bit of the sequel, because I got like the sequel for like £1 in a charity shop, which is not bad buy. Let's see what's in this. Got my shield. Anywhere else I need to go? And also it's like one of those things where it has like, I'm not saying tank controls, but you know, you have to use like the shoulder pads to, you know, change the camera. God, those were, because, you know, this game, I guess, didn't have, you know, add the analog sticks, and despite camera controls, I don't think you can use it. Yeah, you can, because you have to do it like this, which is a bit awkward, you know, back in the day, but, hey, what can you do? That's, you know, ooh, throwing knives, that's neat. Got myself a health potion, need that. Let's go out in the wilderness, fight some zombies, and all that. But yeah, I hope the remaster does well. I'm looking forward to that next year alone. Yeah, we'll just go that way. Looting, looting, looting. And I'm out here. Oh, that's, how do I move? Do I just start from here? That's my own crib. So I don't need to go to my crib. I've already been to the crib, but how do I select the next one? Oh, there we go. Triangle, out of all things. They didn't even prompt you to say, press triangle to move to the next area. God, retro games back then. Anywho. Loading, loading, loading. Yeah, and another reason why I'm not catching on my original PlayStation is because of, it just looks a bit better when playing this on a PlayStation 3, I should say, in terms of caption-wise. I know it doesn't look the best. I did a bit of caption tests beforehand, you know, using the, you know, the original console, I should say, but it just doesn't look that good, to be honest, because I meant to have, like, a frame meister weather when it comes to retro gaming, I should say. Oh, yeah, just use your throwing knives. How do I switch weapons? Nope. There we go. I'd like to use my sword, please. I use my throwing knife, but I should be using my sword. Use my stabby knife. But it just looks good. I love PlayStation at the time. I do still play PlayStation stuff today, you know, game wise on my PlayStation 4 as it is. But I just like, you know, stuff like this when it comes to PlayStation. It's a shame that there aren't not games like this on the PlayStation Classic as it is, I should say. Speaking about games for the PlayStation Classic, here is one of them, and it's Metal Gear. Oh my god, Metal Gear. So we'll try a bit of this, even though you can get this on the PlayStation Classic, but you can actually get this on PlayStation Network as well, even though I do have the original copy as it is. But yeah, let's delve in some good old, Metal Gear. Oh my god, Oregon. Just like my favourite anime. But yeah. I dabbled with somewhat Metal Gear, even though my stepdad at the time did kind of play this, but I know there's quite the fan base, I should say, when it comes to Metal Gear, I should say. But I only played like a few after when the original games came out.
This is Snake.
Colonel, Oregon, Metal Gear. Yeah, dialogue.
You know, knowing cutscenes and whatnot for Metal Gear. But this, however, I have a particular save on this because it does have, if I show you, the certain stuff.
Oh my god, stuff camo! Metal Gear!
I'm just gonna get out. Sorry, bear with me, knowing controls and whatnot. Hello.
Huh? Huh? What was that noise? It's just the box.
It did nothing. It's great cinematic stuff at the time, on the gameplay, because you can hear, they can hear like footprints.
Whose footprints are these?
And all that. It's really good at the time when they made this game.
You can't see me.
Because I've whatever save, because I think I downloaded the save from the internet, because there's a way you can download somewhat PlayStation saves and put on your PS3, which I kind of did, sadly. Ooh. That's funny. Anyways, do I have any weapons? Even if I switch out to my weapon, then I can't use my stealth camo, sadly to say.
Just the box.
Wonder if I have a box. No, just stealth camo. Hold on, just making sure that I... There we go, because if I switch back to something else, like, hey, I'm using stealth camo. I'll quickly show you either way. Let me switch to, Hello! There he is! This is just a tutorial level. Hello. Lol. Knock. Now the next game we're going to be playing now is Medal of Honor, which will be quite cool. A first person shooter game. This is going to be fun. Even I noticed when I was opening the case, it came with some cheat codes. Oh, nifty Steven. I must have did that when I was playing, I should say. I don't think these are cheats for Medal of Honor. I must have misplaced these own codes, I should say, on a different PlayStation game. But anywho, we'll try and play this, I should say, even though that this is a really cool first-person shooter game on the PlayStation, I should say. Hello. Skip. Continue. To victory! Just like my Dalek, poster from that Doctor Who episode from the World War kind of thing. Don't even know why I got that. I just got it because it's a Doctor Who thing. Well, it's set in that time period, I should say. Anyways, let's get to it. And this uses the analog stick, but not the other This uses the other analog stick? I never knew that! Well, I can only, like... Oh, this is weird. Because you use that analog stick to strafe and this to look. Oh, that's awkward. Is there any way to do on the settings? I don't think so. Oh god, it's going to be like one of those particular first person shooter games. How do you shoot? Aim. Okay, that... Oh, it's X. Pow. He did. Hey, I killed someone. But this isn't that bad first person shoot, I should say. Oh, I remember when seeing playing this when you shoot them in the head, the helmets go off. I actually remember that. Funny witch. Hello. Get in the head. Off with the head. Oh, helmet, I should say. Oh, this is good. I know the controls are a bit awkward on the analog stick, I just need to get used to it. Eh. Well, on the camera angle, I should say. Hey, hello. You're not even dead. Die. Hey. How do I reload? Nope, that's a grenade. Oh yeah, it makes sense because if you don't have the analog stick movements, and you can always use like this to strafe and whatnot, which makes sense, common sense for retro gaming. Hello. Pow. Oh, what was that noise? He's behind me. Get him. Hey. Oh. Hey, you did. Yes, the next game we're going to be playing now is Speed Freaks. I know it's not your Crash Team Racing, but hey, this is the thing you can play on the PlayStation, I should say. So we'll do a single race. I like that dude because he's got spiky hair. Right, easy. I like it easy. Which one should we do? Neon Sea looks neat. Alright. Loading. We'll be right back. Huh? Okay. Okay, it doesn't work. Ah, well. Yes, the next game, despite the failure, was Speed Freaks, and there's Digimon Rumble Arena! Yay! I remember playing this despite actually owning the copy is another thing, but yeah. Let's do versus the computer. Let's just hope this one properly loads and not crashes, I should say.
What there we go.
Agumon! Versus. I'll go for that. I loved Digimon back in the day, I should say.
You can do it, Agumon!
Hey! Which arena? That looks like a good arena. I haven't played this for such a while. Well, Digimon's a whole different topic. Loading, loading, loading. Don't crash, don't crash. I would like to play this, actually. Oh. Because it's just Digimon I used to love. Rumble! Oh, kick him. Kick his butt. Ow. Come on, I want to punch you. No, don't get that thing. What's that thing? Come on, I need to digivolve. Take that. Combo. Yeah,
yeah.
Oh, Balder, look out! Oh, got that Smash Bros feel by the looks of it. Kick his butt. Combo.
Pepper breath.
Oh, I can digivolve. How do I digivolve?
Digivolve.
Oh, come on, digivolve too!
War Greymon!
Yay! Oh, it's digivolving! Hey! Yeah, take that! Oh, get that sweet! Oh, no, he's healed! He's got heals! Slice and toss! Yay! Well done! Kick his butt! Something Tornado, I forgot the name. Yay! Whoa, combo! Nearly 10 combo. Ooh, kick his butt. Oh, I de-evolutioned. Because they can't stay evolution forever, unlike...
Pepper breath! Pepper breath!
Because it's not like the other kind of pocket monsters, I should say. Come on, nearly done. Kick his butt. He's only a few health. Oh! 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 Look out for the boulder! Ooh! Care about the boulder. Can we get a replay? I think there was a replay thing. And.
Yay!
I doubt there was a replay. And finally, we're going to be playing one of my most played at the time when the PlayStation came out. My most played PlayStation game I used to play a lot on the PlayStation, and that is this. Yes. Yu-Gi-Oh! Forbidden Memories. Oh, I used to play this quite a lot. I know it's not the original, you know, well, I'm not saying, you know, plays exactly like the card games, I should say. Children's card game, I should say, but this is you know, something that I used to play when I used to play the Yu-Gi-Oh card game at the time, and I know it's not the proper rules, but you know, at the time it was something that I enjoyed playing. Let's take down Sao Kaiba. Screw the rules, I have money. And I watched the Bridge series quite a lot, but you get what I mean. Let's take down Sir Kaiba. I don't have, I've forgotten the name, you know. I've forgotten the name now. You know,
The Unstoppable Exodia!
Exodia! Exodia, I don't have Exodia, but we'll still whip his butt because I have whatever particular cards. And the weird thing is, because like I said, it's totally different to the actual card gameplay, and you have to do like weird ways to. I forgot how to play it now. You know. How do I place him on the field? Oh, that'll do. I forgot how to play it, but it's very different compared to the, you know, actual, you know, card game, I should say. Your monsters are weak. Let's do that. Hold on. Do that and that. I don't think that will work. It's not a fire-type monster. That won't work. Attack! Boom. Somehow it has an effect. That was super effective. Go, Red Eyes! Because they have a Brooklyn accent. Brooklyn Rage. I do love both the Yu-Gi-Oh! Series and the Abridged series in general, but I just love them still. I still, you know, play Yu-Gi-Oh! Today, because, you know, play Yu-Gi-Oh! Legacy of the Duelist quite often, and I still play it today. Take that. Good Red Eyes! Aim for his life points. Yeah. And I got another Red Eyes because I have Brooklyn Rage.
You have no chance against my monsters.
Even though I have one of the deck. Because I have like a whatever save I have on this. Oh, that's how you do it. The gameplay's a bit different, is what I'm trying to say.
Now finish him off with Red Eyes!
Yay! I won. But yeah, I just have whatever save on this, despite whatever cards. S rank! Yay! But yeah, sorry this video was quite a bit long, but other than that though, it was a bit of a nice nostalgia and playing some PlayStation, even though using whatever, you know, PlayStation things I own, despite capturing whatever, and then it is using whatever other games I have laying around. But I do like the PlayStation, and I hope the PlayStation Classic does well, despite its minor performance issues that I've been hearing, and despite I already own quite a number of PlayStation stuff, as you can tell as it is, playing PlayStation today, and not saying I don't see the point having one, but I just have whatever in my utilities to have, and I thought I'll share that with you guys, kind of a bit of a PSA as well. But thank you for watching. I think it was a nice nostalgia trip, I should say, playing the PlayStation with whatever that I have, I should say. Oh, but I'm looking forward to, if a certain company does a certain miniature console, and might buy it, even though I already got that console and a bunch of games for that console as it is. But other than that, though, we'll leave that here. Anyways, I better go now. See you from CT Films.